The couple says they bought three filing cabinets off the side of the road in a local town, but these weren't any old cabinets. They discovered what was supposed to be private and confidential information of more than 200 teachers in the Panola School District in Latimer County, Oklahoma. This is our big story tonight. 4029's Joe Ellison joins us live. And Joe, the Panola School District is demanding the filing cabinets be returned.
But Craig, the couple who bought the cabinets say they're not getting them back. They say the school made a mistake by letting them be sold and wants to give what was inside the owners themselves.
And started tearing the file dividers out of them is when I found several stacks of W-2 forms from the employees of Panola Public School. Oklahoma State education certificate, dates of birth, more social security numbers, amounts of revenue going through the school.
Steve Lee and his wife Terry Meggie say the entire teaching staff's W-2s for Panola School in 1998 and 99 were inside these filing cabinets they bought for $60.
There's enough information there to go and get a driver's license, IDs under someone else's name. You can start draining bank accounts.
The two say they knew exactly what to do.
Just, we want to do the right thing, get the files back to the people that they belong to.
Yeah, I've contacted one lady who still works for Panola Public Schools, and she was not happy when I was able to give her own information over the phone.
That's when Steve says he got a phone call from the Panola School Superintendent.
That is still school property, and I need it back immediately, or I'll have to call the police.
The police did visit the couple, but couldn't legally make them give the files back, so we went to Panola School to talk to the superintendent.
How would that information get out of this school?
By mistake.
Alan Lumpkins says he wasn't the superintendent when the cabinets were sold, but is trying to get the files back.
That this would be dangerous information in the hands of the wrong people.
Right, and that's why I'm concerned why he doesn't return them. Is he a wrong person?
Okay. Well, he says he's going through contacting all the people, just trying to do the right thing here, to hand them back.
But then give them back to us. They're the school property.
But Lee and Meggie say if they gave them back, they would worry something like this would happen again.
So tell me why you wouldn't just give these back to Panola School.
I think someone needs to be held liable. I think the people need to know how loosely their files just went to general public.
They say until they're legally ordered to return the documents, they'll keep trying to contact the rightful owners.
They're kept under lock and key. Steve and I are the only two that knows where they're at. They're not on our premise. They're not kept here. They're in a locked location, and they're kept safe.
The two say for now they're trying to look up these employees, but say it's pretty hard since there are more than 200. But Craig, they say once they track down the owners, they can have their files if they show a picture ID.
It's amazing that they're doing all this. Now, Joe, can the school be sued by the employees for this?
Craig, attorneys we've talked to say there's a good possibility of that if their information was used in illegal activity. Any school is supposed to keep confidential employee information for at least 7 years before they shred it or burn it.
It's the least you can expect. Okay, Joe, thank you. Panola School District says that they're now working with an attorney. They plan to send letters to any employees whose information was in those filing cabinets.